Hi there. So under the heading of equations of motion, we studied what is a graph and how to plot it. Now we'll try to derive equations of motion using that graph. So let's consider the situation. So let's say there's a car which was initially moving with the initial velocity u. Some 5 meter, 10 meter per second, whatever value you want to take, you can take. So the moment I started observing this car was moving with a certain velocity at time t equals to 0. And the car is moving under constant acceleration or uniform acceleration, both means the same thing. Now what's the meaning of uniform acceleration? That means the velocity is changing uniformly. After some time, what I am observing is that my car is now at a different location, let's say at a displacement s, and velocity of the car is v, and time here is let's say t. So instead of 0, my now time is t. If I want to plot this situation on a graph, then how the graph will look like? Let's try to understand. So for this purpose, we are taking a velocity time graph. So if we'll take a velocity time graph, then we are having velocity on y-axis and let's say time on x-axis. So on x-axis I am having time and on y-axis I am having velocity. Now at time t equal to 0, what I am observing is the velocity is u, it's not 0. So this point represents time t equal to 0, and at this point the velocity is some value u, it's not 0. So my graph will start from somewhere here. Then what I am observing is that it's moving uniformly, and at time t, what I am observing here is that my velocity is now v. Now, at time t equal to 0, velocity was u. At time t equal to t, my velocity is v. So this is how my graph will look like. Now, I will try to find out different things using this graph. Now, the first thing will be, what will be the acceleration of this vehicle, which I have plotted on a graph. So we have studied that acceleration was actually change in velocity by time. So you can find out change in velocity by time from here. So what you will get is that v minus u, so v minus u by time taken will be t minus 0, so that will be t, and this will be my acceleration. Now if I'll try to visualize the same thing on the graph, then what is v minus u? This distance is v, this distance is u, so v minus u will be this distance. So this distance will be v minus u. Then divided by time, what is t? T is the length of this part, which is same as this part. So if I am considering this as a triangle, let us assume that this is a triangle which I am taking into consideration, then perpendicular by base of this triangle is giving me acceleration. So for this triangle, perpendicular by base is giving me the acceleration. So this perpendicular by base, we call it slope. So whenever we are having a triangle in a graph and we are trying to find out perpendicular by base of a triangle, we'll call it slope. In this case, value of this slope will be same as v minus u by t. So what we understood from here, that slope of a velocity versus time graph gives me acceleration. So this is the important thing which you will have to keep in mind. So slope of velocity versus time graph gives me acceleration. Now acceleration or the slope A is equal to v minus u by t. So v minus u can be written as A times t, or v can be written as, if you will take it to the other side, you will get u plus A t. So what we did here, we multiplied t with a first, so we got this equation, then we took u to the other side, so it will become v is equal to u plus at. This is the first equation of motion. So this is the first equation of motion. Now, if let's say I'm not interested in finding out perpendicular by base, rather I'm interested in finding out what the area under the curve is. So now my purpose is to find out what the area under the curve is. So area under the curve will be this area. Now this area will have two parts. One part is this rectangle and the other part is that triangle. So let's see what we'll get from here. So if I'll try to find out area under the curve, which I am denoting it with, let's say A. So area under the curve can be written as area of the triangle, which is half base into height. You have studied it in elementary classes. So half base into height will be half base is T and height is V minus U. So half base is T and height is V minus U plus area of the rectangle. Now, if you see area of rectangle is simple, length into breadth. Now, length is T and breadth is U. Length is T and breadth is U. So, U into T. So, now, what we get here is that 1 by 2 into T into V minus U. Now, V minus U can be written as, from here it can be written as A times T. So you can write it as A times T plus U T. Now, if you further simplify it, you will get half into A into T squared plus U times T. And finally, I can write it as area under the curve is U T plus half A T squared. So area under the curve is U T plus half A T squared. Now let's check out what will be the unit of this area. Like for this one, unit of slope will be unit of acceleration. Similarly, if I want to find out what will be the unit of area, then it's very simple. Unit of area you can find out using this relation or this relation. It doesn't matter, you'll get the same answer. So let's say I'm using this one. So unit of the area which we have found out. So we are trying to find out unit of the area which we have found out. So what is the unit of velocity? It was meter per second. And what's the unit of time? It was second. So second and second will get cancelled out, you will get meters. Let's check the second one also. So half is a constant, there is no unit for it, it's a number. For acceleration it was meter per second squared. Into for time it's second squared because T squared is there. These two will get cancelled out. Again what you are getting is meters. So finally we can conclude that unit of this area which you have found out is meters. And if you'll try to recall, meter was the unit for length. So that means whatever this area is representing, it's a length. Since we are dealing with velocity, then this length will be displacement. So what it means that displacement is equal to ut plus half at squared. Where s is the displacement, u is the initial velocity, t is the time, a is the acceleration. This is the second equation of motion. So this was the graph. We tried to find out slope and we got first equation of motion. Then we tried to find out area under the curve, and by checking units we got to know that area under the curve was actually displacement, and the equation for displacement was this. Now this is a homework for you. You will have to use these two equations. So the homework for you will be using equation 1 and 2, you will have to derive the third equation of motion. And what is the third equation of motion? It's v squared is equal to u squared plus to AS. So this is the homework for you. You will have to use this equation as well as that equation. You will have to eliminate T and you will have to find out this equation. Hint for the solution will be, from first, find out the value of T, which will be V minus U by A, and put this value into the second equation. Simplify it, you will get your answer. So you will have to keep all these things in your mind, especially these three equations of motion, and I will see you in the next class. Thank you.